Hi, it's me again, Teacher Mats. For today's finally episode, I'm going to give you tips on how to answer rare jobs interview questions, and I'll also give you a guide on how to do a short demo lesson. Just a little background about Rare Job. It's an online school with Japanese students, and they offer a starting rate of 110 to 150 pesos per hour. Now let's start with the job interview questions. When answering this, don't forget to mention your educational background, job experiences, and highlight your strengths. You can also add up here the position that you are applying for and the reason why you apply. This is to make your introduction complete. If you've already stated the reason why you applied as an ESL tutor on your intro, then for sure the interviewer would not throw you this question anymore. But anyway, let's answer this question. You can say that you wanted to be an ESL tutor because you wanted to share your knowledge and you would want to encourage students that learning English is really important because English is the universal language. And teaching is your passion. It gives you joy and fulfillment every time that you teach, and having that feeling is priceless. So that you can give a better answer to this question, you must do a research about the company. From there, you can get a good reason why you choose Rare Job among the other online schools. You may state here your future achievement as an ESL teacher. For example, you can see yourself in 5 years as a seasoned ESL teacher who could handle different lessons from kids class to business English and even IELTS review. And by that time, you've gained certificates such as TEFL, TESOL, or CELTA. But most importantly, do not forget to give them the assurance that they have your loyalty, that you are still with them in 5 years. Okay, there's no right or wrong answers here because we have our own opinions and beliefs. What the interviewer wants to hear from you is how confident and comfortable you are when using the English language. If you could carry a smooth conversation, please be mindful of your pronunciation and grammar because they will also check that. Please be honest when answering this because they might ask you a follow-up question of your answer. Don't worry if you don't have any teaching experience yet because most online schools now are accepting aspiring teachers and they provide trainings before you will start on board. For newbies, you can say that even if you don't have a formal teaching experience, however, you have taught your siblings or children in their school homework and lessons, or you have tutored a neighbor in his English subject. Much better if you could also mention a training that you've attended and how to be an ESL teacher and the things that you've learned from the said training. That is to show that you also have a great potential in becoming an ESL teacher. Well, I think this is a very easy question, so let's proceed to the next one. Simply tell the things that you did and how you prepared for the interview. Through your answer, they could tell if you really wanted the job, and somehow they could imagine how are you going to prepare for your future classes. The best way to answer this is to give examples of what you have accomplished in the past and to relate them to what you can achieve in the future. Make sure that you are familiar with the company's mission so you can identify the company's specific needs, and then respond by giving examples as to why your education, skills, or experience will make you an asset for the employer in fulfilling these needs. Right now, most online schools are looking for online teachers who could work during peak hours, so that's from 7 p.m. to 11 p.m. They will prioritize those applicants who can work during peak hours. Be prepared for a follow-up question about the hobbies that you're going to say. For example, you say that you love cooking, so they might ask you a recipe of one of the dishes that you cook. Or you like reading, then they might ask you about the book that you've read. Again, in this question, they just want to check your fluency in English. Simply tell the things that you do in your everyday life, and please be mindful of the proper tense that you are going to use in your sentences. The time word everyday should be used with simple present tense. In here, they wanted to see how you handle things. If you are optimistic, if you have the positive attitude, if you are not a quitter, because these are the characteristics that they're looking for as an ESL teacher. Be careful in giving your answer here because the interviewer will then ask you a follow-up question of what kind of person are you? So try to think of an answer that best describes of who you are. For this question, try to think of a superpower that could be useful or could somehow relate to your job as an ESL teacher. For example, a superpower to read people's minds so that in your class, you would know what your students are thinking, or if they have questions in their mind but they're just shy to ask it to the teacher, so you would still know. And that's all for the job interview questions. Now let's move on to the demo lesson. This activity will be done right after your interview. Here's how to do it. Yuki-san, our lesson goal today is to be able to use is and are properly. Is the lesson goal clear to you? Okay, let's continue. Is used when the subject is singular. For example, the girl is reading a book. While are is used when the subject is plural. For example, the three girls are walking to the store. Is the lesson clear to you? If the student's reply is no, so you have to explain further and give more examples. Okay, Yuki-san, let me explain more. If the subject is only one, it could be a person, animal, or thing, then that is singular. Singular means only one. Girl, boy, bag. Those are the examples of singular. Only one. So we use is. So we will say the girl is, the boy is, the bag is. Plural means two or many. For example, girls, boys, two bags, three dogs, people. Those are the examples of plural, two or many. So we use are. Let's say the girls are, the boys are, there are two bags, there are three dogs, the people are. Okay? Is the lesson now clear to you, Yuki-san? Great! Now let's have some practice. You will choose the correct answer if it's is or are. Are you ready, Yuki-san? Okay, let's start with number one. Alright, in this part, if this student's answer is wrong, then you have to correct your student. You can say it like this. Oh, Yuki-san, let's answer again number two, okay? These five oranges is or are delicious. In our lesson, it says is for singular, only one. And are is for plural, two or many. So can you please give me the correct answer for number two? Good job! That's the end of our finally episode, and I hope you get a lot of tips from today's video. By the way, guys, those are only sample answers, so please do not copy exactly what I've said, or you may draft a much better version of my answers. If you want to get more ESL video tips, then please do subscribe and hit that bell button so that you'll be notified every time that I post a new video. If you want to know about the trainings that we offer, please check them on our Facebook page or you can also join in our community. Once again, this is Teacher Mats, your coach to your ESL journey.